easy to interpret visualizations that make use of flood inundation mapping, FIM, can be an effective tool for enhanced decision support. As shown in the NWM maximum inundation extent video, the National Water Model FIM, or NWM FIM, uses the height above nearest drainage method, or HAND, to derive the maximum extent of surface inundation. In this video, we will explain FIM that is derived using flow forecasts from the NWM. It is important to note that only reaches which are forecast to reach the above high water threshold will display the NWM FIMs. High water is defined with an annual exceedance probability, AEP, which is related to the average return interval, ARI. The estimated high water threshold information was derived using a National Water Model multi-decadal climatology. There are a few key features worth noting when using FIM derived from NWM flow forecasts. First, as of late 2021, NWM FIM was available for 715,000 river miles in the south central and eastern seaboard of the United States. As of 2022, NWM FIM is generated for roughly 3.4 million river miles throughout the United States, including Hawaii, Puerto Rico, and the Virgin Islands, small portions of southern Canada, and a small portion of Mexico near the Rio Grande. Second, the flow forecasts used for deriving NWM FIM visualizations are the same as flow forecasts used in other NWM services. For example, a forecaster or decision maker can use an NWM visualization, such as maximum high flow magnitude, as guidance for where to zoom in for flood inundation information. Third, FIM based on NWM input is updated regularly. That's every 6 hours for the medium range forecast and every hour for the short range forecast, giving forecasters updated inundation information on the same cycle as other National Water Model visualizations. And fourth, the NWM FIM provides maximum inundation extent forecast for any reach within the given time period, including 18 hours, 3, 5, or 10 days. And different time periods within the medium range allow the user to identify the changes in the inundation extent with respect to time. How does NWM FIM acquire the information needed to derive FIM in its stream reaches? NWM FIM is computed using synthetic rating curves, which convert the forecast flow to stage height for stream reaches. NWM FIM is limited by the representativeness of the NWM flow forecasts, and only computed when the flow exceeds the estimated high water thresholds. The derived synthetic rating curves are typically not as representative as those rating curves which are derived from direct field measurements. As of 2022, the spatial resolution of the grid used for the NWM FIM is 10 meters. This is coarse compared to flood inundation maps that are derived with LIDAR or other high resolution elevation models that may exist. It is possible that NWM FIM may not resolve the extent of inundation or structures such as local levees or culverts, as well as FIMs that use higher resolution digital elevation models. The NWM FIM provides important information about inundation extent, but there is currently no direct depth information provided. So how might this information be used to increase the situational awareness at WFOs?
The community of Anytown is planning an outdoor festival and parade on the first weekend of May to celebrate its bicentennial. The festival will take place at Creekside Park along Watery Creek. Heavy rain is forecast for Friday night, and the maximum high flow magnitude service forecast high flows on Watery Creek during that weekend. Watery Creek is not covered by a River Forecast Center forecast point. As we zoom in, we can see from the National Water Model flood inundation mapping that the main road leading to Creekside Park is on the edge of the forecast inundation, and the main creek walk area is forecast to be inundated. What we see here informs us that we should investigate other data to assess confidence regarding the risk of flooding in this location. We will use documentation of historical floods and our office's local knowledge of areas that tend to flood in these situations.
So as you can see, the NWM FIM is only one option in a set of guidance tools that can be used to assess the inundation risk and increase the situational awareness of potentially flood-prone areas based on the NWM output. In summary, the NWM FIM provides forecast of flood inundation that can be used for situational awareness. It is available for roughly 3.4 million river miles throughout the United States, including Hawaii, Puerto Rico, and the Virgin Islands as of summer 2022, including previously unserved stream reaches. It shows the maximum extent of inundation over a time period. It does not contain any direct depth information. The NWM stream flow forecasts used as input to NWM FIM are the same flows used with other NWM visualizations, and they are updated regularly with precipitation forcing and observed gauge data.